taking one more example, then you take others as assignments, and I'm sure you'll be able to do that when you follow the steps closely. Now we assume we have a complex number which is x, and the components are minus 1, minus I. How are we to work this? Don't forget to be using the same procedure as we used for the first example. So there is nothing to worry about. Just take it easy, and you'll be able to do that. So the first thing we do is represent this on the complex plane, as we usually do. Imaginary real address. So we have minus 1 on the real address, so minus 1 would be on the left-hand side of the plane, because that's where the negative numbers are. We also have minus I, which is eventually negative 1, so we have minus I also below the imaginary axis, because the negative numbers for imaginary axis also fall below. Now, we can say that they both meet here, and we draw a complex number on the plane. And don't forget to label the magnitude here R. The magnitude from the origin to where the I minus this is 1. Don't forget, in our previous lessons we talked about magnitude as absolute numbers. They are always positive no matter how they look like, even if the distance is negative, because we only want the actual movement, which is 1. And also from the negative 1 to the origin on the real axis is also having a magnitude of 1. And our theta, we say we always start from positive real axis till we get to the complex number and its magnitude. So this is what theta will be. Now let's continue by finding the value for R. Since we have 1 and 1, 1 squared plus 1 squared, final answer is 2 as well. Let's try finding theta. Now let's take a look at the diagram very well. We can find out that from this part of the angle to this part only is half a revolution, which is already equal to pi. So we only need to find this remaining portion that I've shaded, then we add it to what? Pi, to get our full theta. So let's label the shaded region as a beta, which we'll be finding. So tan beta, which falls within these quadrants, will be the opposite here over the adjacent, and the opposite is 1, the adjacent is also 1, so tan beta is still 1 over 1, which is equal to 1. So our beta becomes tan inverse of 1, which is equal to 1/4 pi when we calculate that with our calculators. So we can finally say our theta, which we are to find at the beginning, is this pi that we have resolution or resolution plus the shaded region left, which is also pi over 4. So when we add pi to 1/4 pi, we are eventually getting 1/5 of pi, which is 5 pi over 4. So that's our theta now. So we can rewrite our complex number in polar and angular forms. So for polar form, we are going to have x to be equal to root 2, which is r, bracket open, cos theta, which is 5 pi over 4 plus I sine 5 pi over 4. As simple as that. And in our angular form, we are going to get root 2 our natural e with 5 pi over 4 I as the power. So that is the upper part is the polar form and the lower part is the angular form. So that's all we have to do. So I would like you to take these two examples and try it on your own. If there are still more questions, you can send us your worries through our emails or after subscribing, you have the opportunity to send us more questions. So you take this and try your hands on that. One plus root 3i number 4. We also have polar form to change minus 2 minus 3 root 3i. There is nothing to fear. Just pass through the same procedure. Then you'll be able to write both in polar and angular forms. Are we expecting to see this as you work? Then you can send the solutions, and when there are any mistakes, we do that. So